na 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 not Batman. I gotta come up with better intros. Really, it's just. So, just saw Birds of Prey, and I gotta say, it wasn't that bad. Of course, it wasn't that good either. Look, if you're gonna watch this movie and you're gonna say, oh, it's all woke, no, it's not. It's Deadpool. That's all it is. It's just not as funny. So, the biggest issue with this movie is that it doesn't have the humor that Deadpool has. And it has a couple of the, look, Margot Robbie, who I have an unhealthy attraction for, don't worry, I'm not going to be a stalker, but I'm willing to learn. You know, she really owns the role. You need to watch it, and you need to say, okay, what am I really watching this for? And if you really want to see an acting tour de force, Margot Robbie is probably the most talented of the next generation of actresses that are coming up. So I really like that about it. She really owns Harley Quinn, but I don't understand what they were trying to come up with here, because Harley Quinn is the movie, and the Birds of Prey are almost a sideshow, and there's not really much to them. I didn't hate this. I liked Ewan McGregor's Black Mask. He was great. I didn't see a bunch of feminism in there. And quite frankly, this is where I'm looking at it going, all right, guys, what are we really upset about anymore? Are we seeing so much woke stuff in these movies that we assume that if there's a bunch of women in a movie that it must be woke and feminist? Because if it is, it's a very poor representation of feminists. It might be a very accurate one these days, but I wouldn't say it's a very good representation of feminism, because everybody in this is terrible. They're just terrible people. Now, I'm okay with that. Harley Quinn is just somewhat less terrible than the rest of them, but overall, it's just terrible people, and they're just fighting for survival against worse people. And so, you know, you just want to go and turn your brain off, have some good fighting sequences. I get a little annoyed when we say, oh, this girl couldn't take down all these men. Yeah, we know that. But if you've been watching the DC animated universe like I have, and you were taking it hook, line, and sinker, I don't know if you noticed or not, but Batman in the DC animated universe started jumping 20 feet in the air. He was supposedly the one with no powers. So when it comes to these superhero movies, I really don't give a crap about it not being completely realistic. What I do like, what I do want to see, is am I enjoying myself? And in this movie, it was sometimes yes and sometimes no. They did the whole beginning of the movie, just like Deadpool, where you had tell a little bit of the story, then narrate flashback, then tell a little more story, then narrate flashback, and go back to something you just saw. It works in Deadpool. It doesn't work here. I was just rolling my eyes and going on to the next thing. I don't want to see what I just saw if you're not going to up the ante a little bit emotionally. Secondly, as good as Margot Robbie is in the role, whatever jokes or whatever humor was there just fell flat to me. There are one or few moments I think I did laugh at, including the death of the bad guy. But, spoilers. But I wasn't laughing like I laughed in Deadpool. If you're going to go R-rated and you're going to go with a cursing, then let's get a little imaginative with it. It's clear that the budget was lower with this movie, and it all, as far as set dressing and all that, all went to the last scenes. And the rest of it just looked like it was shot in some city, which is Gotham. but it's some city, and it was kind of cheap. But I didn't see the wokeness in it. I didn't see the feminist in it. And that's where I get irritated, because the critics saw what they want to see, which is, hey, look at all the feminism in here. You got to love this movie. And we're already getting the anti-feminists, people who I generally identify with. And if you watch my Ghostbusters, you know I don't like feminism.
Fuck Paul Feig. Fuck feminism.
See? So just my bona fides there. But that doesn't mean that I want to go into every movie that I see expecting to be pissed off. I want to go in and give it a fair shot. And that's what I did with this movie. And quite frankly, it wasn't that, it didn't have all that in it. Did it have problems with plot? Yeah. Did it have characterizations I didn't like? Yeah. Did every actress really pull her weight? No, not really. For instance, Mary Elizabeth Winstead, who plays the Huntress, she was great. And, you know, they were like, she was supposed to be so cool. And in fact, she's rehearsing in the mirror, trying to be cool and failing miserably. And I like that. I liked that Cassandra Cain. I didn't like that it was Cassandra Cain. Cassandra Cain's supposed to be this badass ninja. She was nothing. She was just a pickpocket and she didn't know what the hell she was doing. So just make a new character. Why take the badass ninja and make her not? There was no point other than, hey, here's a name the nerds will recognize. It's Cassandra Cain. We'll put her in the movie. That was dumb. But the character itself, if it wasn't Cassandra Cain, the idea that she couldn't kick ass at anything. And most of the time, the women were trying to protect her. And that was the other thing I really liked about this, which I'm afraid feminism, this isn't very woke. You're going to have to deal with this. But in their own twisted way, there was a motherly instinct going on here. And I appreciated that. And you don't see that very often. Now, I know it sounds like I'm heaping a lot of praise on this movie, and I'm not. It was fine. It was an enjoyable 2 hours of the movie where I wasn't pissed off, but I wasn't wowed. It was fine. It was the definition of 50%. Or 60%. It was good enough. The action scenes, when directed by the action director, were very good and very imaginative. The ones that were not, not so much. For some reason, Black Canary, who was supposedly one of the major ones, she wasn't very good. The actress wasn't very good. There was a scene where she comes into the apartment building and there's Cassandra Cain. So they have this connection. Why do they happen to live in the same apartment in all of Gotham? Because we needed a connection and we were too lazy to figure out a different way to do it. So that was terrible. And there was a lot of little things like that. Harley Quinn comes in a very enjoyable sequence and fires beanbag gun, at all the police officers. Police officers never think to draw their weapon. Not once. I don't know why. I don't know why they didn't just shoot her. Maybe she would have gotten the drop on a few of them, but when she walked in, it was almost like they were just waiting to get hit. So I didn't like that. I didn't like that when she let Cassandra Cain out of prison, that's the whole reason she went in, is to get her out. All the prison, the cells opened, and all the prisoners came out. Why didn't they leave? I get that the point of the story is that since she broke up with the Joker, which by the way, she acts just like a jilted lover, just like her whole world has crumbled. I kind of got a kick out of that, like her man doesn't love her anymore, so now she's a mess. Nothing wrong with that. But why, so everybody wants to hurt her, and I get that. But these guys in prison, is this really what they want to do right now? They're out. They can leave. So leave. Just leave. Just go. What are you doing? Why are you going to beat her up now? Because we have to have a fight scene, of course. So there's a lot of things like that. Now, some of that I could put up with if I felt like it was being funny. The humor was just, it wasn't like cringy or bad. It was just, blank, you know? Like, the humor is just like, okay, I get it. Didn't make me laugh. And that's what you really needed in this movie, and that's where the movie fails to me. It's not the feminist stuff, because there wasn't that much in it. It's not, you know, bad superhero or acting, because for the most part, everybody did very good, except for Black Canary. I wasn't impressed with her. Ewan McGregor seems to be having a great time. He was actually the funniest thing in the movie. And you know, they kind of pushed the R rating a little bit. And I get what she was trying to do, what she was trying to accomplish, and where she ended up. And I was kind of okay with most of that. These are all villains, they're all terrible people, and you gotta accept that in this kind of movie, and I was okay with that too. But as far as if you're going to do that, make me laugh. You know, really take it, and it, in a weird way, I felt like the movie was safe. Like, they didn't want to take it too far. They want to be crazy, but crazy in a safe kind of way. This was the Deadpool 2 problem with me. Deadpool 2 was crazy in staying crazy because of the way the first one was crazy. And we don't want to do anything different than the first one did, because that's what people want, so we got to do the same thing. And so they ended up not pushing a single boundary in Deadpool 2. And this feels like a Deadpool 3, just with different characters. We gotta do all the same stuff they liked in Deadpool 2, and we gotta bring in the Harley Quinn-isms, but we don't wanna do anything really too far out there. This is what people are gonna be expecting. And so, a big nothing would be a better, it was kind of a big nothing. Again, I can't say that it sucked. It just, I'm gonna forget, I'm having trouble remembering parts of it now. So you're not going to come out of it like you've just seen something amazing. You're going to have to run out and see it again. But it's not going to piss you off. It's not going to annoy you. I enjoyed myself while I was there. Can't say I care about it that much more. So, again, there you go. Give it a 6 out of 10. I don't know. I don't care. 3 out of 5. 3 out of 5, because we do 5 stars on there. I don't even remember my own site. I don't know how I did it. I'm the one who set it up. I don't care. So, there you go. Go out and see it. I can't really recommend to go out and see it. It didn't anger me. And if you're saying, well, this is a big feminist mess, then I don't know what movie you saw, because I don't see that in there. I get concerned when you get so twisted up looking for the wokeness that in your own weird way, you become woke yourself. Because that's what you're looking for, but you instead of looking to support it, you're looking to be pissed off at it. It's not worth your time, man. This movie especially is definitely not worth your energy getting that emotional over. It's a big slice of meh, and that's fine. So what? I've gotten mad at movies like Ghostbusters, if you've seen it, and if you haven't seen it, Get on my YouTube channel, subscribe, and watch my backlog of video. This is a lot of work, you know? I had to buy lights and green screen, all kinds of shit here. Cameras and more lights, and it's really hurting my eyes right now. So please, watch these videos, like, share, subscribe, and then go to lastmovieoutpost.com, where you can see that we have new news stories every day. And if you have a scoop, or if you have something you want to tell us about, or just ask us a question, email us at contactus@lastmovieoutpost.com, and hit us on YouTube, like I said, subscribe, or go to Twitter. You'll find me at Drunken Yoda. I believe we have at Last Movie Outpost, and you'll also find us on Facebook, Last Movie Outpost. So please visit us at any one of those places, and I will see you in the next video.